If you have a complex function f of z, you can express it as u plus items v, or vice versa. If you have u and v, you can express your function as f of z and z bar. You can use brute force from the first to the second or vice versa, but it's often possible to do this a bit smarter. You will see examples of both the brute force and the smarter method in the examples in this video. So let's start with the function f of z equals z bar over z, and we want to find u and v. Well, this function goes from c without 0 to c. You cannot plug in 0, of course, because then you're dividing by 0 over there, so our domain will be all of c, with the exception of 0. Let's try to find u and v. So what should we do? We can just plug it in mindlessly, but we can also think a bit first. If you multiply by 1 by z bar over z bar, then you get in the denominator the norm of z squared. And that's something nice, that's just x squared plus y squared. And in the numerator you get z bar squared, so you have to do something over there. If you wouldn't do this first step, you would have to work out a quotient later on. Now, after this step, the denominator becomes x squared plus y squared, and in the numerator we get z bar squared equals x minus I y squared. Work out the denominator, we get x squared plus I squared y squared, so minus y squared, minus 2 times x times I times y, so minus 2 x y times I. So we can read off what our u and v's are. Our u is just x squared minus y squared over x squared plus y squared, and our v, the imaginary part over here, minus 2 times x times y times divided by x squared plus y squared. So going from f of z to u and v is not hard at all. Just plug in z equals x plus iy and z bar equals x minus iy, and do it a bit smart whenever possible. Now we go the other way around. That's usually a bit harder. So we have now our u and our v. And the question is, can we express f in terms of z and z bar? First, the brute force method, which will always work. So what you can do, you can express x in terms of z and z bar, because we know z equals x plus iy, z bar equals x minus iy, so if you add them you get z plus z bar, the iy's cancel out and you get 2x. So you can solve for x. X equals z plus z bar over 2, and similarly for y, y equals z minus z bar over 2i. Now you can plug those x's and y's in everywhere in your function. So the x squared becomes z plus z bar over 2 squared, minus y squared becomes minus z minus z bar over 2i squared, the minus 2i becomes minus 2 times z minus z bar over 2i, and then we have a 2ix, so 2i times x over here, and a minus 2i times x times y. Work out the brackets, so the 1 over 2 yields a 1 over 4 if you square it. Z plus z bar squared yields z squared plus z bar squared plus 2 times z z bar. The other term, 1 over 2i, if you square that, you get minus 1 over 4 with the additional minus sign. You get a plus 1 over 4. And working out the square, z squared minus 2 z z bar plus z bar squared. Over here. And then the other terms, minus 2i over 2, the factors 2 cancel out. And the minus 1 over I gives you plus I times the z minus z bar. In the other term, just the factors 2 cancel out here and there. So you get an I times z plus z bar. And in the final term, the z 2i's cancel out over here. So you're left with a minus 1 half z plus z bar times z minus z bar. So z squared minus z bar squared. And then you see that a lot of terms are going to cancel out. First of all, we have a quarter z squared plus a quarter z squared equals 1 half z squared, and then a minus 1 half z squared, so no z squareds. Then we have 1 half z z bar minus 1 half z z bar, so those cancel out as well. Then we have a quarter z bar squared, another quarter z bar squared, so a half z bar squared. And here with the minus sign, another half z bar squared. So full z bar squared. And what do we have left? We have an I times z over here, and I times z, so 2iz, and a minus iz bar over there, plus iz bar, which cancel out. So all we're left with in the end, we had a huge expression which we have only left, z bar squared plus 2iz. So if you get an answer like this, you know that you probably could have done this a bit smarter. And yes, why is that? The second method. Well, you can recognize your x squared minus y squared minus 2xy. You see, well, if you have x plus y squared, you get x squared minus y squared plus 2xiy. Seen that you will see that quite often. So you recognize here that's almost like that, apart from the sign. So you see this combination equals x minus iy squared equals z bar squared. And then you just collect what you have left, minus 2y plus 2xy, so the remaining terms. Take out the factor of 2i and you see, oh, you just have 2i times x plus iy. So you recognize that this is 2i times z. And then you have your final answer as well. So if you recognize certain terms, you can do this type of exercises a bit faster. But you can always do them anyway using the brute force method 1.